afternoon, everyone, and welcome to Live at 4 on this Tuesday. I was driving around in the countryside today. The trees are really starting to change.
They're starting to change now. It's October 5th. It doesn't feel like it, does it?
Not going to for the long range, the way it looks. We'll get to the weather in just a minute. But first, some of our top stories today include a smash-and-grab job on Madison's west side. Dozens of cars with windows busted out were live from where it happened.
Plus, a week normally filled with school spirit and celebrations is tempered, but still going on in Middleton after three local students died in a car crash.
And Facebook's terrible week did not improve today. We'll hear from the whistleblower testifying on Capitol Hill on how the company treated people. Let's take a look outside. It feels a little more like end of early part of September.
It does, yeah.
Early part of October. Still mild, still cloudy. The leaves are starting to fall. Dana's in the backyard, waiting for the cooler weather.
Oh, patiently waiting at this point. And you're going to have to be a little patient if you're hoping for a big cool down, because this mild trend really sticking with us. Here's a live look over Madison right now. Quite a cloudy sky yet again for us today. Temperatures yet again close to 70. We're at 68 right now in Madison with dew points in the upper 50s. So it does feel just a little humid outside this afternoon. Doppler track quite quiet outside throughout the state, really. We're not looking at any light shower chances popping up for this evening. Near 70 across the board this evening compared to this time yesterday in a very, very similar spot. With the light breeze passing through, about 8 to 15 miles per hour for most of southern Wisconsin from the northeast. Enough that you might notice it every once in a while, but certainly not windy outside. Overnight temperatures only dropping to the upper 50s yet again, so another mild start to tomorrow and another mild afternoon expected for our Wednesday. A very steady pattern for us right now. Variably cloudy skies for your Wednesday. High temperatures will be in the middle to lower 70s. By the end of the week, we'll see a little bit of a change with some rain chances getting introduced. We'll look at that 10-day in just a few seconds. As far as traffic conditions right now, we are seeing a bit of a delay there along the Beltline currently. The interstate, though, north and southbound looks smooth for us in Rock County. To get from the Beltline to Janesville, 25 minutes, 16 minutes from Middleton to Sauk City and downtown Sun Prairie, an 18-minute drive this evening.
All right, Dana, thank you. Madison police expect to hear from many more people with all with very similar stories today. Their cars broken into, windows often smashed, and lots of things missing.
It happened overnight, mainly around an apartment complex on the west side. And that is where our Brad Hamilton joins us live this afternoon. Brad, what did you learn?
Well, Susan, we've all seen that classic grab and go. Their thieves are trying to get in and out. I have never seen, since I've started reporting a couple of years ago, I've never seen so many cars smashed in. We've seen so many, and Madison police agree. They say this is very unusual, and they're calling this very serious. And most of all of these crimes, most of which came from this apartment complex right behind me here. It's an extremely nice area, as you can see. But police were called out here to around 2:30 a.m. Originally, they were just coming to calls of teenagers apparently checking on car doors, but when they arrived, it got far worse. And in total, they're saying now around 20 cars were smashed in, had their windows smashed in, and we don't know yet if anything was stolen, but that's a heavy number. Now, we also got a chance to speak with management here at Stone Creek, and they're believing that that number is actually a lot higher. They're saying they believe 35 cars in their indoor and outdoor parking got hit from this string of crimes. Now, we got a chance to speak with the assistant property manager here, who is frustrated with this really strange and complex series of crimes.
We are on it and we do care. This is not something that happens regularly. Even though, you know, it can happen anywhere, we are sad that it has happened here. And unfortunately, just the minds of some people and what they will do and go to for fun, it is very unfortunate.
MPD has not said yet if any suspects have been identified. They've also just said that this is something that they're really trying to crack down on because, again, that's a high number, that 20 number. Now, it could get higher if the complex here is right at that 35, but 20 alone, that's a lot of car damage. Now, coming up at 5, we're going to hear from a person that actually had one of their windows smashed in, and he actually says he had some items stolen from him. We're also going to hear more from Madison police. Reporting live in Madison, Brad Hamilton, News 3 Now.
Brad, thank you. Human remains found in a suitcase in Chippewa County are confirmed to be that of a Reedsburg woman missing since last year. Yesterday, the Chippewa County Sheriff's Office confirmed the remains were of 25-year-old Rosalie Cindy Xaviera Rodriguez of Reedsburg. Rodriguez's remains were found in a suitcase in the town of Wheaton in Chippewa County on October 14, 2020. Authorities said they had a person of interest and plan to release more information later on.
Fitchburg police have arrested a woman in connection with a deadly weekend stabbing. Kanaya Quinn was booked into the Dane County Jail on a tentative charge of first-degree intentional homicide. The victim was 62-year-old Fred Edwards Jr. He was taken to a hospital where he later died.
Tributes and donations are pouring in, honoring the three high school students killed in a crash near Middleton over the weekend. Today, we learn Middleton High School will still hold its homecoming celebrations, hoping to unite the school after the tragedy. Students Jack Miller and Evan Cratchwell and Madison West student Simon Balesi died after their car was hit west of town late Saturday. The district also shared photos of Miller and Cratchwell for the first time. Meanwhile, a GoFundMe page raising money for the boys' families surpassed $90,000. The Dane County Sheriff's Office says investigators are still working on possible charges against the driver who they say hit the boys' car. Tonight at 5 and 6, we're hearing from classmates and also how Balesi's soccer club is working to honor him. A former Facebook employee turned whistleblower testified before Congress today.
Frances Haugen testified about how she believes the social media platform harms young people. Skylar Henry reports from Capitol Hill.
They're paying for their profits right now with our safety.
Frances Haugen testified before a Senate subcommittee Tuesday about the need for greater oversight and transparency of Facebook.
The choices being made inside of Facebook are disastrous for our children, for our public safety.
The whistleblower worked as a product manager on Facebook's civic integrity team, but left the company earlier this year.
Regularly, integrity actions, projects that were hard fought by the teams trying to keep us safe, are undone by new growth projects.
Haugen told lawmakers Facebook and Instagram use algorithms to target teens, exposing them to dangerous content that could make them develop eating disorders.
Facebook understands that if they want to continue to grow, they have to find new users. And the way they'll do that is by making sure that children establish habits before they have good self-regulation.
By hooking kids.
By hooking kids.
Lawmakers on both sides of the aisle are united in condemning Facebook CEO Mark Zuckerberg and vowed to enact reforms.
Here's my message for Mark Zuckerberg. Your time of invading our privacy, promoting toxic content, and preying on children and teens is over.
Facebook pushed back against Haugen's testimony in a statement, saying they don't agree with her characterization of the many issues she testified about.
If Facebook wants to discuss their targeting of children, I am extending to you an invitation to step forward, be sworn in, and testify.
The company says it agrees it's time to create standard rules for the internet and has called on Congress to act. Skylar Henry, CBS News, Capitol Hill.
President Biden went to a Michigan suburb near Detroit to sell his infrastructure plans to the American people. But his Build Back Better agenda remains stalled in Congress as talks continue among members of his party. Vermont Congressman Peter Welch is one of several Democrats who've spoken with the president this week to hash out a way forward on the roughly $1 trillion bipartisan infrastructure bill and a larger social spending measure.
Going to have to come down on the number, and we may have to come down on the duration, and we may have to come down on the scale.
Meanwhile, Congress has less than 2 weeks to raise the federal debt ceiling, or the U.S. could run out of money to pay its bills. Senate Majority Leader Chuck Schumer plans to bring up a House-passed measure to suspend the debt limit tomorrow.
There's a new theory about what may have caused a large oil spill, which is having a major impact on the Southern California coast. Up to 144,000 gallons of oil have already leaked into the ocean there, shutting down beaches and putting animals in danger. Monday, the CEO of Amplify Energy, which operates the pipeline, said there's a possibility a ship's anchor may have ruptured the line.
We have examined more than 8,000 feet of pipe, and we have isolated one specific area of significant interest.
Despite concerns about the impact on wildlife, an initial assessment found only 4 oily birds so far, compared to the thousands discovered during a spill in 1990.
A Dane County committee assigned to come up with plans to redevelop the Alliant Energy Center met today to hear updates on developer proposals. The committee was formed 2 years ago to see what could be done with the 164-acre campus and surrounding neighborhoods. The virtual meeting explored what state funding might be available for any development, along with interest from the private sector. One committee member said if there is any hope of getting state money, rural Republican legislators need to be convinced there is value in making an investment in a facility in Dane County.
Mayor Satya Rose Conway releases the highlights of her 2022 executive operating budget for the city of Madison today. In this operating budget, the mayor proposes funding priorities that attempt to outline a path forward on many challenges facing the city today, many of which are outgrowths of the COVID pandemic. There were 4 main points of her budget plan for 2022.
Ensuring equitable city services to new residents from the town of Madison. Innovating on violence prevention and public safety. Investing even more in affordable housing. And supporting our diverse city workforce.
The budget includes $6.59 million to expand housing choices, make needed home repairs, and take on energy-saving retrofits.
Governor Evers announced 2 new grant programs totaling $75 million to support diverse business investment in communities impacted by the pandemic. The governor made the announcement today in Milwaukee's Dominican Center alongside business leaders representing some of Wisconsin's ethnic and diverse chambers of commerce. The $75 million grants will be split by 2 programs, one to provide money to local community banks and another going directly to small businesses. Jessica Cavazos from the Latino Chamber of Commerce talked about how important those small businesses were during the pandemic.
After COVID, small businesses turned into triage centers, helping keep the economy afloat with technical assistance, mentoring, connecting small businesses with resources to keep their doors open.
Just before the news conference, there were multiple gunshots fired just blocks away from where the governor was supposed to speak. The conference eventually continued as normal, but for a short time, there was concern for the governor's safety.
If you needed a job on the weekends or just want to pick up some supplemental income, there was a part-time job fair at Madison College this morning that continues tomorrow. Companies like Culver's, FedEx, Target, and UW-Madison took part in the fair, which is free and open to the public. It was very well attended by both companies for employees and job seekers.
We were excited when employers started coming. All of our slots were filled. Only one employer canceled. And the reason why he canceled was because he filled his position, and we're okay with that. So we're very happy with the attendance. The traffic flow seems to be really good right now, and we're hoping to see the same thing tomorrow.
The job fair does continue tomorrow in person at the Truax Atrium and online on Thursday. More details are at joinhandshake.com. Well, still to come at 4, a lot of movies have been set in space.
And now, for the first time ever, a movie is going to be filmed in space. We'll have more on that when Live at 4 continues.
You're watching News 3 Now, Live at 4.
Like a great night's sleep on a new mattress from Steinhoffels. Right now, get a queen mattress for the price of a twin on select Serta Perfect Sleeper and Beautyrest mattresses. And when you upgrade to a Beautyrest Black, you'll get $200 in Steinhoffels cash. Plus, with free delivery and Steinhoffels 120-night sleep guarantee, you can't make a mistake. Only at Steinhoffels and Steinhoffels.com.
Join Anytime Fitness for just $1 now through October 12th. Anytime Fitness gives you 24/7 support with expert coaching on all things fitness, nutrition, and everything in between. Now through October 12th, join for just $1. Visit AnytimeFitness.com today.
No more Freon for your AC. Oh no, the homeowner's called Action Man and his action team.
Call on Action Plumbing, Heating, and Electric at iwantactionnow.com.
About $100 off a complete pair, frame and lenses. Wisconsin Vision. See more life.
Do you struggle to open or close your windows? Are they drafty or leaky? Are you constantly adjusting your thermostat only to have your energy bill skyrocket? If you're nodding your head yes, Renewal by Andersen is your best solution. They custom build and install weather-tight replacement windows and back them with a generous, fully transferable limited warranty.
Call now to schedule your free design consultation. Plus, take advantage of this limited-time offer with incredible savings and attractive financing. Don't miss out. Call Renewal by Andersen today.
Or a high rise, protect it with fire sprinklers. Fire sprinklers buy time, time buys life. Learn more at firesprinklersbylife.com.
Welcome back. After 40 drawings without a Powerball winner, the streak was broken last night.
One ticket in last night's drawing matched all six numbers to win a nearly $700 million prize. The winning ticket was purchased in California. The California Lottery says the winning ticket was purchased at Albertson's grocery store in Morro Bay, which is near San Luis Obispo. The winner has not come forward yet, but whoever it is will pocket $496 million. After taxes.
Isn't everybody a millionaire there already?
Well, that's a it is. It's a beautiful area. I think we'll know, though, because I don't think you can stay anonymous in California, so we'll eventually know.
Well, hello from the other side.
You're not going to sing it?
No.
Adele has confirmed that she is about to release a new song. According to her announcement on Twitter, the song is called Easy on Me and will drop next Friday. The Grammy award-winning singer hasn't released new music since her 2015 album, 25. Some of her fans have shared pictures of billboards saying 30, which is what she has previously revealed as the title of her new album. Adele has not revealed a release date for it yet.
Fans of Game of Thrones got a sneak peek at the newest installment releasing next year. The official teaser for House of the Dragon dropped online today. The Game of Thrones prequel focuses on the Targaryen family who can control dragons in this fantasy world. The series takes place 200 years before the end of the original series. House of the Dragon is set to air on HBO Max in 2022.
The U.S. has resumed flights for Afghan evacuees. The Department of Homeland Security says planes are once again taking off from military bases in Germany and Qatar. Flights were paused last month after four cases of measles were discovered among the Afghans. The CDC recommended the move. When evacuees arrive in the U.S., they are vaccinated for measles, mumps, rubella, and chickenpox. More than 49,000 Afghan evacuees have now been vaccinated.
Incidents involving unruly airline passengers are at their highest level in months. That's according to the FAA. More issues reported in the last week than any week since July 20th. A majority of the disruptions, 72%, were over the federal transportation mask mandate. More than 4,600 incidents have been reported so far this year. The FAA says it has a zero tolerance policy for unruly passengers.
Pope Francis is responding to to an investigation that found systemic abuse in the French Catholic Church. The investigation found members of the clergy in France sexually abused more than 200,000 minors since 1950. The report found up to 3,200 people who worked for the church abused children. The pontiff says he is grateful to the courage of the victims. He denounced the abuse and says he hopes the Church of France will redeem itself.
AstraZeneca has filed for an emergency use authorization in the United States for its COVID-19 antibody therapy. The company says it prevents symptomatic COVID-19, particularly among those who don't get an immune response from vaccinations. Based on its trials, the drug reduced the risk of symptoms by 77%. More data on the treatment is expected later this year. If granted by the Food and Drug Administration, it would be the first long-acting antibody combination to receive emergency use authorization. AstraZeneca says it is still discussing supply agreements with the U.S. and governments around the world.
Johnson & Johnson is asking the Food and Drug Administration to approve its COVID-19 booster shot. J&J hasn't asked for a specific time interval to administer the booster. Instead, the company submitted data showing a second shot boosts immunity to 94% when given 2 months after the first dose and boosts immunity response 20-fold when given at 6 months. Johnson & Johnson says protection from its vaccine remains stable over time. That is in contrast to Pfizer, which told officials its vaccine's efficacy wanes over time.
On Wall Street, stocks had their best day since August. The Dow Industrials added 311 points, ending the day at 34,314. The NASDAQ gained 178. The S&P 500 was up 45.
Well, Captain Kirk is really going into space nearly 250 years before the time of the original Star Trek.
We learned yesterday that William Shatner, now 90 years old, will travel on the next Blue Origin space flight due to lift off 1 week from today.
This morning, a Russian rocket carried another actor into orbit. She's ready to tour the International Space Station and turn it into a movie set, as Elizabeth Palmer reports.
If all goes well, this launch will make movie history. Aboard that rocket, after a summer of training, are actor Yulia Peresild, director and cameraman Klim Shipienko, and cosmonaut Anton Shklyaplerov. They docked at the space station on Tuesday so they can begin their mission to shoot a movie about a surgeon played by Peresild who flies into orbit to save an astronaut's life.
Well, it's a stunt.
Professor Ian Christie, a Russian movie expert, says the project is at least partly political. It's no coincidence that massive publicity around the movie comes just as the Kremlin's struggling with a lethal COVID surge and President Putin's popularity is sagging.
Undoubtedly, it is propaganda.
But the state's paying for the whole thing.
Yeah.
In Hollywood, space is classic blockbuster material.
Good to go.
And it was a Hollywood rumor about Tom Cruise planning a movie in space with Elon Musk that fired up the Russians. Of course, the competitive element is there, says the movie's director. Tom Cruise also really wants to do this. Russia has had big wins in the space race with America. The first dog in orbit, the first man and woman, and now the first movie.
It sort of speaks to something that has this deep roots in Russian culture, a belief that, yes, man should reach the stars.
But then he and she must return to Earth. They've already practiced the landing to face the next critical challenge at the box office. Elizabeth Palmer, CBS News, London.
The space race ain't over yet.
Oh, no, that's just going to be something when William Shatner takes off.
I can't wait.
I know, I can't either. I can't believe he's doing it.
All right, well, many restaurants are having a hard time finding workers during the pandemic.
So some are turning to robots to take orders and to deliver food. We'll have that story coming up after Dana's Firstborn Forecast.
A nursing home promises to care for our parents as cherished loved ones. But if your parents have been injured in a nursing home, we can help. Habish, Habish, and Rotier. We fight for what's right.
Fur,
You won't phase me. Unlike Zyrtec, Allegra won't make me drowsy.
Allegra starts working 2 times faster than Claritin. So take Allegra before allergy symptoms take over you. And for kids, try allergist-recommended non-drowsy children's Allegra.
Everyone remembers the moment they heard, "You have cancer." How their world stopped. And when they found a way to face it. For some, this is where their Keytruda story begins. Keytruda, a breakthrough immunotherapy that may treat certain cancers. One of those cancers is advanced melanoma, which is a kind of skin cancer where Keytruda may be used when your melanoma has spread or cannot be removed by surgery.
Keytruda helps your immune system fight cancer, but can also cause your immune system to attack healthy parts of your body. This can happen during or after treatment and may be severe and lead to death. See your doctor right away if you have cough, shortness of breath, chest pain, diarrhea, severe stomach pain or tenderness, severe nausea or vomiting, headache, light sensitivity, eye problems, irregular heartbeat, extreme tiredness, constipation, dizziness or fainting, changes in appetite, thirst or urine, confusion or memory problems, muscle pain or weakness, fever, rash, itching or flushing. These are not all the possible side effects. Tell your doctor about all your medical conditions, including immune system problems, or if you've had an organ transplant, had or plan to have a stem cell transplant, or have had radiation to your chest area or a nervous system condition.
Today, Keytruda is FDA approved to treat 16 types of advanced cancer and is being studied in hundreds of clinical trials, exploring ways to treat even more types of cancer. It's true. Keytruda from Merck. See the different types of cancer Keytruda is approved to treat at Keytruda.com and ask your doctor if Keytruda can be part of your story.
At U.S. Cellular, we know the local landscape, so we can help everyone stay connected for less. And less also means more, as in more choice. While the other guys may limit your options, at U.S. Cellular, you choose any phone and we make it free. That's right. Visit our store and any phone you see is free. Plus, get unlimited data for $30 a month and get the most out of our state-of-the-art network, wherever you choose to go. U.S. Cellular, America's locally grown wireless.
What does it mean to fight for what's right? To us, it means helping accident victims get their lives back to normal again. Habish, Habish, and Rotier. We fight for what's right.
Well, take a look at this. This woman shooting the video says she and her husband were traveling through Tennessee when they got caught up in a traffic jam. After sitting in the congestion for a while, she noticed vehicles were using the emergency lane to cut around. But this is what really tickled her. That truck up ahead is over just enough to not let the cars pass. She says the trucker's message for them was, not today.
Yes, a nice try there.
Well, today is National Eat Fruit at Work Day.
It's marked every year on the first Tuesday in October. People are encouraged to pack fruit in their lunch, eat it as a snack at your desk, or try a new fruit-filled recipe. The holiday was founded, of course, to promote the benefits of getting more fruit in your diet. You're a big fruit eater.
Yeah, I love it. Look at the size of these blueberries.
They're delicious. Where's Dana?
I'm here. I need my antioxidants.
Would you like some?
Could you feed me a grape?
There'll be a viral moment.
Right. We don't need to do that to anybody right now. But yeah, these are huge. That's crazy. Awesome. We're at work. We're eating fruit.
Yeah, it feels like summer.
I eat blackberries every morning.
Really?
Mm-hmm. They're good. They're really good for you.
Is this before or after you eat your pickles for the day?
Yeah. Pickles are late.
These are good. And it does, like you said, it is very summery outside. Yeah. Or not summery. Well, like, at least it's
mild. Very mild.
Yeah. Mild for us.
First part of September or so.
It does. It does feel like that. And as we look ahead to the rest of the week, things are going to stay pretty mild outside. We'll take a closer look at your full forecast right after the break.
No grape?
I'm getting there.
Join Dr. Ashish Raval to learn about the most common types of injuries in young athletes and how to prevent them. This workshop is a must for any parent of a student athlete.
Here at TSR, we transform old, cracked concrete floors into beautiful, tough floors in just one day. Hi. I'm Joey with TSR Concrete Coatings, and here at TSR, we don't just simply coat over your old concrete. We grind it down, repair it, apply the base coat and chip, and then seal it with our own proprietary sealant that will never chip or peel. All of our coatings are covered by our exclusive lifetime warranty, so you can rest assured that your beautiful new floor will last. Our awesome team is here to answer all of your questions before and after the installation. And right now, we are offering 15% off your new floor coating until the end of the year. Visit the website or call that number below for your new floor today.
TSR, one day floor.
Call 1-800-886-8411.
Attic Angel Community has earned a reputation as the one and only. But what's so memorable to the people who live here?
It's good local heart.
Interesting friends.
The view from my window.
Continuing education.
The food.
The amazing art studio.
Happy hour.
There are many reasons to love Attic Angel Community, but there's just one Attic Angel.
I just saw your national TV ad with Joe in it. Can you tell me more about the money you say I can have put back into my Social Security? It's not available in my area? Did you just say that I need to read the fine print? Is this legitimate? Is this legal?
National call centers, they're just not the way to go when you can meet with a trusted and knowledgeable Medicare insurance agent from Informed Choice Insurance Agency. Because nobody knows your local hospitals, doctors, and pharmacies like your local Informed Choice Insurance agent.
Hi, I'm Dr. Sheesh Raval with the Ortho Team Clinic at Stoughton Health. We hope you can join us for our upcoming event on preventing injuries in young athletes.
News 3 Now First Warn Weather is brought to you by Lazy Boy Home Furnishings and Decor.
Discover a shopping and design experience as comfortable as the furniture. Lazy Boy Home Furnishings and Decor. Schedule your free design consultation today.
Again, it does feel a little more like maybe mid-September at this point as opposed to early October. Temperature-wise, we are going to stay above average through the rest of the work week, the weekend, and through all of next week. So it's a very mild trend for us in the 10-day. For the weekend, or for Wednesday, excuse me, we'll stay dry outside, similar to today, holding on to mostly cloudy skies with mild temperatures. But as we get into Wednesday night and then Thursday and Friday, some rain chances will creep in and we will have more of a soggy set up for the back part of the work week. Right now, our Doppler track is quiet. We do have some clouds hanging out overhead, though. None of these clouds squeezing out any moisture, though. Yesterday, we did see a few light drizzle spots. That's not so much the case for us this afternoon. Overnight, we're still mostly cloudy outside, so temperatures won't fall too much. At close to midnight, we're still near 60 degrees, and overnight lows will only drop generally to the upper 50s. So a mild start to the day tomorrow. Not too cool outside just yet. Afternoon high temperatures will be in the mid to low 70s with our breeze coming in from the east southeast. We'll have a little more cloud coverage expected for the late evening. And then as we go overnight into Thursday, our rain chances start to build in. That's going to lead to scattered showers for us throughout the day on Thursday. Notice we'll have dry time mixed in there as well, but it's going to be one of those days where you might want to keep the umbrella in the car because you might not need it running into work, but you might need it maybe running from the car back into the house later on in the day. So having the umbrella on hand will be a good idea for Thursday. And the same goes as we look ahead to Friday, very similar with that rain pattern. In general, our 6 to 10 day outlook trending above average with a little more rain in the forecast through much of next week, off and on shower chances. Again, not expecting a washout, but a few more shower chances really building in. Temperature-wise, really anchoring and doubling down on this warm trend. Cooler temperatures off to the west, where they're seeing a lot of rain and a cool trend. But for the eastern half of the country, we're all seeing these temperatures really trending above average. For this time of year, we should be in the mid to low 60s for afternoon highs. And for tomorrow, we'll be in the middle to low 70s. We'll stay in the mid to low 70s for the rest of the work week, with more rain chances expected to really stay with us again Thursday and Friday. Friday. Saturday, very unseasonably warm outside. We'll be close to 80 degrees at that point, almost 20 degrees above average for Saturday afternoon. A slight chance for a shower or thunderstorms, a better chance building in for Sunday and the start of next week. And notice for next week, almost every day, we'll at least have a small chance to pick up some rain coming through. So some more showers building in, more of a soggy setup for next week. But temperatures will stay above average for afternoon highs and overnight lows. Not dropping for us too much just yet. Even as we look ahead to the middle of next week, we're still holding on to those 50s for overnight lows, guys. So not concerned too much about a drop off on our temperatures right now.
Well, middle of October, still warm.
Still mild, yes.
All right. Thank you, Dana.
Thanks, Dana.
The pandemic created a major shortage of workers at restaurants. Now, some businesses are turning to technology for help.
Elise Preston explains.
There are some new employees at the Dallas restaurant Leduni, three robots that can greet customers and deliver meals. The owner says it's not a novelty, but a necessity because he can't find enough workers.
I had people who tell me, well, they're taking people's jobs. Guess what? No, they're not taking anybody's jobs because there's no one showing up. What they are doing is helping the ones who are really working.
Sergio's restaurant in Miami is also employing high-tech help for the same reason.
We can't service the entire restaurant. So 30% of our restaurants, dining rooms are closed because we just don't have the staffing to fulfill the demand.
The robots allow servers to handle more tables. It's a trend happening in restaurants around the world, from Seoul, South Korea, to this establishment in Iraq, using a conveyor system to get meals to customers.
Restaurants are definitely going to become more automated.
Martin Ford is the author of Rule of the Robots. He says restaurants started using technology like ordering kiosks and robots that deliver food to homes before the pandemic. Now, White Castle is experimenting with a robot to help in the kitchen. And the salad chain Sweetgreen recently bought the company Spice that created a robotic restaurant in Boston.
Whether you like it or not, I think it's a trend, so the best thing is that we all find ways to adapt to it.
Customers at Sergio's seem to be adapting.
I've never seen anything like that before. Honestly, it surprised me.
I was like so surprised. It's really cool.
More diners may be in for the same surprise, with more restaurants turning to robots to help create a recipe for success. Elise Preston, CBS News, New York.
It's only a matter of time, Susan.
Yes, it is.
Coming up next on Live at 4, Consumer Reports helps us with smoke detectors.
And then next hour, speaking of the worker shortage, at 5, our Christina Laurie takes us inside the restaurant worker shortage here in Madison. That's coming up at 5.
I'm not getting through the pandemic just to end up with the flu.
I asked for Fluzone High-Dose Quadrivalent.
It's the number one used flu vaccine for people 65 and older.
Fluzone High-Dose Quadrivalent is the only vaccine approved by the FDA for superior flu protection in adults 65 plus.
I'm not letting my guard down.
Fluzone High-Dose Quadrivalent isn't for people who've had a severe allergic reaction to any flu vaccine or vaccine component, including eggs or egg products. Tell your healthcare professional if you've ever experienced severe muscle weakness after receiving a flu shot. People with weakened immune systems, including those receiving therapies that suppress the immune system, may experience lower immune responses. Vaccination may not protect everyone. Side effects include pain, redness, and/or swelling where you got the shot, muscle ache, headache, and general discomfort. Other side effects may occur.
All flu shots are not the same. I raise my game with Fluzone High-Dose Quadrivalent.
Ask your doctor or pharmacist for Fluzone High-Dose Quadrivalent.
Fry Construction is celebrating 26 years of providing excellence in home improvements. We strive to exceed the expectations of our clients with each and every project we do. Respected by your neighbors and voted Best of Madison 2 years in a row. Best kitchen and bath design, best roofer. Experience the Best of Madison for yourself and save 26% off gutters or insulation with any full roofing project. Schedule your consultation today at fryconstruction.com.
Start your next project and save with 11% off everything at Menards. Platinum Plus Paint and Primer in 1 features Stain Shield technology, providing up to 50% more stain resistance and washability. Save today with 11% off all Dutch Boy interior paint, whether working from home or relaxing for the evening. Sylvania Two-Way Bulbs mimic natural sunlight and deliver superior dimming control. Right now, get 11% off all Sylvania LED light bulbs.
Save big money at Menards.
McGann Furniture in Baraboo has a question for you. Have you ever bought a piece of furniture in a box and then had to put it together yourself? We know, it's not fun. At McGann's, everything is professionally inspected and assembled before pickup or delivery. Goodbye headaches, and there's no extra charge for assembly. And remember, at McGann's, we don't inflate prices only to mark them down for a sale. Stop in soon and discover the difference. You'll be glad you did. McGann Furniture, downtown Baraboo.
In tomorrow's Eye on Education, I'll share how local schools are helping students cope with grief.
And meet a man running to raise mental health awareness in the 608.
And our unsettled weather pattern sticks around. We talk rain chances tomorrow from 4:30 to 7.
Every day, News 3 Now investigates, taking action to discover and report the facts to make sure your voice is heard. That's why News 3 Now investigates. You're watching News 3 Now at 4, winner of the National Edward R. Murrow Award for overall excellence in television.
Well, it's happened to all of us, that annoying low battery chirp that only seems to go off in the middle of the night.
Right.
Or the smoky dinner dish that trips the sensors. We're talking about those annoying smoke detector false alarms.
As Consumer Reports explains, there are some easy ways to keep your alarms connected properly so they only go off when they're supposed to. Our Leah Linscheid has more.
We've all experienced it, that loud, piercing, deafening sound of a smoke detector. But Consumer Reports says resist the urge to take down your alarm or remove its batteries.
Always assume there's a fire. When you've determined that it's safe, then you can get to the root cause. Some of the things that will cause an alarm to go off are dying batteries, steam from a shower, dust, or even spiders inside the alarm.
Let's start the fixes with an easy one. The battery, replace it every 6 months. If it's sealed in the unit, replace the unit every 10 years. To reduce other alarm triggers, it helps to understand how detectors work. There are two main types of detectors, photoelectric and ionization.
Photoelectric alarms respond to particles in air created by smoldering fires or steam showers. They're less prone to false alarms caused by cooking, so consider them for areas near kitchens.
Ionization alarms, on the other hand, are triggered by the small particles given off by an open flame, so an active kitchen will often produce false alarms. They're better installed near steamy bathrooms. For the best protection, Consumer Reports recommends dual sensor alarms, which use both types of technology, or a combination of photoelectric and ionization alarms throughout your home. Consumer Reports recommends this First Alert 3120B or this Kitty P12010. For News 3 Now, this is Leah Linscheid.
Consumer Reports also says don't install smoke alarms near windows, doors, or ducts where drafts might interfere with their operation. And also don't forget about your basement.
Yeah, place a smoke detector on the ceiling at the bottom of the stairs leading to the next level. I can't make a pizza without the smoke alarm.
Oh, yeah.
I turn on the oven and the dogs run upstairs because they know the thing's going to go off. Maybe I should clean the oven.
Yeah, maybe.
Boosters and antibody therapies are making COVID headlines today.
We'll get all the latest COVID news from UW Health, Dr. Jeff Potthoff, when Live at 4 continues.
Not only does a seamless LeafGuard gutter system add beauty to your home, it's also the last gutter system you'll ever buy. It's guaranteed to never clog or we'll come out and clean them for free. My team will give you a free estimate and you'll get a $100 Visa gift card with your order.
Hello, I'm Roman Ryan of Ryan Funeral Homes. As a locally owned and operated funeral home, it's important to know that not all funeral homes are the same.
Some other Madison area funeral homes are actually owned by corporations based outside of the United States. A corporately owned funeral home is focused on the bottom line, making services more costly. We have served local families for more than 80 years, and our priority is investing in the community and your family.
In your time of need, Ryan Funeral Homes are here for you.
Do you suffer from chronic or severe back or neck pain? Did you know that there is now a treatment method available right here at Midwest Spine and Nerve Center that offers hope of avoiding spinal surgery for those suffering with bulging, herniated, or degenerative discs? Our therapies help reduce pain related to these conditions and have a high success rate in helping people just like you avoid back or neck surgery.
I've experienced low back pain for over 15 years. I had back surgery when I was 26 and had difficulties recovering. The doctors at Midwest Spine and Nerve Center have given me a new lease on life. I am now able to enjoy an active, pain-free lifestyle.
Call Midwest Spine and Nerve Center now to schedule a no-obligation consultation to see if our progressive pain-relieving therapies are right for you.
What makes new SalonPas Arthritis Gel so good for arthritis pain? SalonPas contains the most prescribed topical pain relief ingredient. It's clinically proven, reduces inflammation, and comes in original prescription strength. SalonPas, it's good medicine. Send me to...
Go on, girl. Go on and get help.
Smart dog. With Farmers Crash Assist, our signal app can tell when you've been in a crash and can send help if you want it. Get a whole lot of something with Farmers Policy Perks.
We are farmers. Bum, 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 bum.
About $100 off a complete pair, frame and lenses. Wisconsin Vision. See more life.
LeafGuard is the only gutter system to earn the Good Housekeeping Seal, the leading symbol of quality, assurance, trust, and safety in America. And LeafGuard is guaranteed to never clog. My team will give you a free estimate, and you'll get a $100 Visa gift card with your order.
Well, the traffic map starting to pick up a little more with this few accidents for us in the last about hour or so. As we look at the Beltline, actually, westbound, we did see an accident near Stoughton Road that has since been cleared, but the delays surrounding that area, you can still see those slowdowns along Broadway and, again, for some parts of the Beltline right now. Looking along the interstate in Dane County, 3990 southbound right now. The right lane's closed, but traffic is backed up significantly all the way up to 94 right now. So that's southbound 3990 just outside of downtown Madison. And as far as Rock County goes this evening, no delays for Janesville or north and southbound on the interstate in Rock County right now. From the Beltline to Janesville, 25 minutes, 16 minutes to get from Middleton to Sauk City and downtown to Sun Prairie, an 18-minute drive this evening. That's a quick look at traffic.
Dana, thank you. Well, this will certainly mess with traffic. Amateur footage of an out-of-service Air India aircraft went viral after it was filmed squeezing narrowly under multiple overpasses in New Delhi. The aircraft was purchased at an auction by a restaurateur who has started a chain of airplane-themed restaurants called Runway One.
Ooh, that's a tight squeeze.
You see that on the Beltline?
Yeah.
Pause. Well, 2/3 of adults in the U.S. are now fully vaccinated, and nearly 2.8 million people have already received a third booster shot.
The CDC today released guidelines for holiday travel, so there's lots to talk about with UW Health's Chief Quality Officer, Dr. Jeff Potthoff.
Welcome back.
Hi, good to see you guys.
Hi, good to see you.
Same.
So, UW is pretty compliant. People had to be first vaccinated by October 1st, mm-hmm. second by November 1st. What are the numbers there?
So, we're looking pretty good. So, of our 16,000 employees, a 99.96% are compliant with that vaccine mandate, which is just a real testament to the commitment of our staff to not only take care of themselves, but to take care of their community.
Do you think those mandates are a big step toward addressing the vaccine gap?
You know, I think for two reasons. One, it puts people in a position where they need to make a decision, but also it encourages those employers to then talk to those employees, understand what those gaps are, clear up that misinformation, and really get folks to understand why this is probably a good thing for them to do.
Let's talk about this antiviral therapy that's coming out, Merck and AstraZeneca. What's the science here?
Yeah, so it's really interesting science. So viruses, what they do is they use the machinery in our cells to replicate themselves. They give our machinery a secret code. What this medicine does is actually inserts additional letters into that code so it gets scrambled and the virus can't replicate. So it's kind of virus espionage in a way, which is kind of a cool way to think about it.
And when is that, when you get that treatment? After you're diagnosed or is it a preventative?
Right, so the study looked at folks who got it early on within their COVID infection who would likely have risk of getting severe disease. And when you give it to those folks, a small study, but a phase 3, about 750 people, it reduced hospitalization by about 50%. that.
Wow. But this is not in place of a vaccine.
No, so if we look at our vaccines, you don't have to get COVID in the first place, but vaccines, you know, 90%+ effective in preventing disease. You know, this, you know, 50-50, so impressive, but not as good as a vaccine.
What about the booster shots? A lot of people are getting them now. If you don't fall within the category that qualifies for one right now, if you're not immunocompromised or I think it's 65 and older, mm-hmm. are you still protected? If you're fully vaccinated?
You know you are. So when we look at the data and we look at those folks who got, in this case, the Pfizer vaccine, that protection's still there. Now what starts to wane is the likelihood of you getting a breakthrough infection. And that breakthrough infection is likely to be very mild, might not be much more than a cold. You may not even know that you had COVID. So there's that balance between going through the process of getting vaccinated when the benefit is only this small benefit for breakthrough infections versus older folks, immunocompromised folks, where when we see breakthrough infections that lead to severe disease, it's in that population. That's why the vaccine booster is recommended for them. Mm-hmm.
But it's only the Pfizer.
Right now, the only booster we have approved is the Pfizer. We have Moderna kind of waiting, now Johnson & Johnson in the wings.
That happened today. Mm-hmm.
But if you have Moderna, you can't get the Pfizer booster.
Right now, there isn't a recommendation to mix and match those. And with Moderna, the durability is a little bit better than the Pfizer vaccine. That immunity kind of holds on for a bit longer.
The CDC issued its holiday travel guidance today, and it said that it's probably the safest way to celebrate the holidays is to do it virtually. Now, what is that telling us?
Yeah, you know, I think this is tricky because the CDC maybe has a crystal ball that I don't have, but it's hard to know what COVID's gonna look like at the end of November and in December, if cases are gonna be high, if that'll be universal, if there'll be areas of the country where cases are lower. So I think, although I think it's important to get guidance out there, it will be safest to say, hey, let's do that virtually, let's distance, let's keep those masks on. If Delta calms down, cases decrease, there may be parts of the country where it's not as high risk to those things. Kudos to the CDC for coming out with this. Things could change a little bit before we get to Christmas.
And some prominent doctors, national doctors, have disagreed with that. They say it's okay if you're vaccinated.
Yeah, I know. I think that's where it gets tricky because, things are different in different parts of the country, and especially the CDC is speaking for the entire country.
Especially if you have kids that can't be vaccinated.
Yeah.
That's where the problem's coming in.
How important do you think it is to get a flu shot this year?
You know, I think it's real important. I think we're going to see more flu cases this year than we saw last year. We have a lot of COVID cases right now. The last thing we want is flu patients competing for COVID patients, competing with the rest of the folks that need hospital beds for our hospital beds this fall. So the good news is that you can get that flu shot and that COVID booster at the same time. So maybe one appointment, get both shots, two birds, one stone, that'd be the way to do it.
Do you think everybody will get boosters? Or just select groups?
I think, at some point we'll see where everyone gets a booster. I think the big difference will be timing. When is the right time? When do we see immunity waning enough for those folks that are healthy, that have a good immune system, where they need a booster? And I think we'll probably see COVID vaccination boosters on a similar timeline as flu. Maybe it's once a year, maybe it's a little more duration than that, every 2 years. But I think we're gonna see boosters for COVID-19 sticking around.
Every week, we have so much to talk about.
We do, we need more time.
Doctor, thanks for being with us
we
again.
We appreciate you.
Next week.
Yeah, good to see you.
Same.
We'll have a final check of your forecast coming up.
It's no secret. Robertson is Wisconsin's aesthetic leader, but with results this natural, patients can keep it a secret if they want. Our secret to the best skin of your life, HydraFacials. Book a free consultation to learn how HydraFacials are different at Robertson.
Discover what's in store at Habitat Restore Dane County. You'll find something new every time you visit to keep your project on budget with low price and high quality home supplies. For one-of-a-kind items, shop Habitat Restore Dane County today.
All Denny's pancakes are made to order with fresh buttermilk, but this month's Spotlight Stack feels like fall and is the pumpkiniest, pecan pie drizzliest, and most gram-worthy of them all. New pumpkin pecan pancakes, this month's Spotlight Stack. See you at Denny's.
Here at TSR, we transform old, cracked concrete floors into beautiful, tough floors in just one day. Hi, I'm Joey with TSR Concrete Coatings, and here at TSR, we don't just simply coat over your old concrete. We grind it down, repair it, apply the base coat and chip, and then seal it with our own proprietary sealant that will never chip or peel. All of our coatings are covered by our exclusive lifetime warranty, so you can rest assured that your beautiful new floor will last. Our awesome team is here to answer all of your questions before and after the installation. And right now, we are offering offering 15% off your new floor coating until the end of the year. Visit the website or call that number below for your new floor today.
DSR, one day floor.
Call 1-800-886-8411.
Life in the 608 is all about how you live it, and there's plenty of inspiration.
This is just an idea that I rolled with.
I'm News 3 Now's Josh Spreider. I'm visiting the people, places, and events that make this area one of a kind.
Who's the evil twin?
Tell me what inspires you, and it might be featured on News 3 Now this morning.
My motto is, be the change you want to see in the world.
In the 608, weekdays on News 3 Now this morning.
It doesn't get any better than this.
There's a live look over Madison right now. That cloudy sky is still holding on. If you're hoping to hold on to this mild weather as well, some good news as we look ahead through the rest of the 10-day, temperatures will consistently stay above average. We're also going to hold on to the dry weather for tomorrow. Rain chances will start to creep back into the forecast by Thursday and for Friday. We'll be right back.
One of the best ways to protect your biggest investment, your home, is to replace your gutters with a lifetime LeafGuard gutter system, guaranteed to never clog and warranted forever. My team will give you a free estimate and you'll get a $100 Visa gift card with your order.
Habitat homes are built and bought by the hardworking families that live in them. Through affordable mortgages backed by your donations, Habitat Dane County offers a chance for these families to invest in their future and their community. Please donate or volunteer today.
Attic Angel Community has earned a reputation as the one and only. But what's so memorable to the people who live here?
It's good local heart.
Interesting friends.
The view from my window.
Continuing education.
The food.
The amazing art studio.
Happy hour.
There are many reasons to love Attic Angel Community, but there's just one Attic Angel.
Advanced non-small cell lung cancer can change everything, but your first treatment could be a chemo-free combination of two immunotherapies that works differently. It could mean a chance to live longer. Opdivo plus Yervoy for adults newly diagnosed with non-small cell lung cancer that is spread, test positive for PD-L1, and does not have an abnormal EGFR or ALK gene. It's the only FDA-approved combination of two immunotherapies. Opdivo plus Yervoy equals a chance for more time together, more family time, more quiet time. Opdivo and Yervoy can cause your immune system to harm healthy parts of your body during and after treatment. These problems can be severe and lead to death. See your doctor right away if you have a cough, chest pain, shortness of breath, irregular heartbeat, diarrhea, constipation, severe stomach pain, nausea or vomiting, dizziness, fainting, eye problems, extreme tiredness, change in appetite, thirst or urine, rash, itching, confusion, memory problems, muscle pain or weakness, joint pain, flushing or fever. These are not all the possible side effects. Problems can occur together and more often when Opdivo is used with Yervoy. Tell your doctor about all medical conditions, including immune or nervous system problems, if you've had or plan to have an organ or stem cell transplant or received chest radiation. Here's to a chance to live longer. Ask your doctor about chemo-free Opdivo plus Yervoy. Thank you to all those in our clinical trials.
When you replace your gutters with a LeafGuard gutter system, you're getting peace of mind that your home's foundation is being protected and you'll never have to climb that ladder again. My team will give you a free estimate and you'll get a $100 Visa gift card with your order.